Hello students, now we shall look at the advantages and disadvantages of wind power. India of late has installed a lot of wind turbines for power generation as it's a renewable source of energy. And one of the leading nations, I think in the top 5 with the installed wind capacity. So I'd just like to tell, like every house what we have, so we consume almost 2 to 3 kilowatt of power, if it is not air conditioning house, normal house, so 2 to 3 kilowatt. But today you have got wind turbines, each wind turbine almost generates 2 megawatt, 2000 kilowatt. That is as good as one turbine is able to cater to 1000 houses. Okay, so keeping this background in mind, now we can think, what are the advantages? The wind is free and with modern technology it can be captured efficiently. So wind is absolutely free, no cost of any fuel, no transportation cost, maintenance is also very least, and it can be captured efficiently. You have got the aerodynamic wind turbines. Once the wind turbine is built, the energy it produces does not cause greenhouse gases or other pollutants. So absolutely it is eco-friendly, no pollution, like in diesel power plant, coal power plant, you have got the gases, carbon dioxide and other gases going, but here no pollutants. Although wind turbines can be very tall, each one takes very small plot of land. This means that the land below can still be used. This is especially the case in agriculture areas, as farming can still continue. So the land required for installing the tower especially is very less. Maybe around 20 feet by 20 feet only, okay, not more than that. And the nearby area, land can be used for agriculture purpose. Whereas you take a coal power plant, huge amount of land is required for incoming coal, for the power plant and the dust, fly ash and all. Many people find wind farms as an interesting feature of the landscape. Remote areas that are not connected to the electrical power grid can use wind turbines to produce their own supply. See, one thing is, this grid supply power is there in most of the cities, towns and villages also. But there are some houses and some villages with less population where the grid connection, these cables are not gone, electrical power cables are not gone. There you can have decentralized wind turbines so that it generates there and it is consumed there itself. So this transmission and distribution losses are reduced. So wind turbines have a role to play in both developed as well as third world, means that is a developing world. So both India is a developing country, so here also it has got a role to play, like other countries like Germany, France, they have got a lot of wind turbines. Wind turbines are available in a range of sizes, that means a vast range of people and businesses can use them. Single households to small towns and villages can make good use of the range of wind turbines available today. See, when I look back at the wind turbine growth in India, earlier days you have got 200 kilowatt power plants initially, but today you have got almost 2 megawatt power plants. So 10 times the growth has happened, and the so 200 kilowatt means it can cater to 100 houses, and 2000 kilowatt means it can cater to almost 1000 houses. So one plant only, it can cater to either hundreds of houses or thousands of houses. So they are available in various sizes now, and so it can be used by even small villages and even small towns. It's a renewable, wind is a renewable source of energy, so it is not depleting, it is not going to end. It's a pollution free and does not cause any global warming, because other power plants like coal, thermal power plant, they cause global warming. They require very less space for installation. They are very effective source of energy and ideal for countries with infrastructure issues, because other coal power plant and other equal lot of infrastructure. Here there is no much issues, and also it can help in the generating employment as well as local employment for the local people for maintenance. Now let us look at the disadvantages. The strength of the wind is not constant and it varies from zero to storm force. So wind, like our bike and our diesel power plant or coal, you cannot control the wind speed because it varies. So This means the wind turbines do not produce the same amount of electricity all the time. So the electricity generated from the wind turbine, output of the wind turbine also varies. And when the wind speed is low, that time it produces no electricity. On an average, around 20 to 25% of the time, they produce electricity. Okay. So many people feel that the countryside should be left untouched without these large structures being built. The landscape should left in its natural form for everyone to enjoy. Because of the birds and all, people feel that nowadays you have seen the countryside also a lot of windmills have come. They also make, wind turbines make noise. So each one can generate the same level of noise as a family car traveling at 70 miles per hour. So they definitely generate noise, and as we have seen in the earlier discussion, the wind turbines have to be located 500 meters away from the houses so that the sound does not come to the house. And they should also be away from the main roads, 50 meters away from the road, so that they don't cause problems to the road traffic also. And 1 kilometer away from the city. Many people see wind turbines, large wind turbines, as unsightly structures and not pleasant or interesting to look at. They disfigure the countryside and are generally ugly. Now, this is also subjective matter actually. Some people find it attractive, some people do not find it attractive. Wind turbines are being manufactured, some pollution is produced. Therefore, wind power does not produce some pollution. So, no, when power, these wind turbines are being built, at that place they use energy and some pollution is there. Large wind farms are needed to provide entire communities with enough electricity. For example, the largest single turbine available today, we can provide electricity for 475 homes when running at full capacity. This is not India actually. As I was telling, how many would be needed to for a town of 1 lakh people? Like Karwar has got a population of 1 lakh. So depending on, as I told, almost 2 in Karnataka. See, India per capita energy, electrical energy consumption is very low. Okay, so even one turbine can cater to 500 to 1000 houses also in our place. And because of the variation, it is not a reliable source of energy. I was telling, it is only generating for 20 to 25% of the time. Whereas a coal power plant or a diesel power plant, you can, or hydel power plant, you can run it for 24/7. As long as you have got water or you have got that fuel. And storage is, of course, energy, whatever is produced has to be used, it cannot be stored. And it generates only temporary employment, only for maintenance. That maintenance is not a daily affair. It poses a threat to the wildlife, especially birds and bats. And also, some people feel it interferes with the aesthetics, the looks of the region. So these are the advantages as well as disadvantages of wind turbines.